Today we proved position 4.3 and 4.4. For an integral domain D, we have the following properties. The first property is x is a unit if and only if x divides 1. So we start with x is a unit. That implies y such that there exists y such that xy is equal to 1. That implies x divides 1. On the other hand, if x divides 1 implies there exists y such that xy is equal to 1. So this shows that x is a unit. The other statement is any two units are associates, and moreover any associate of a unit is again a unit. If we take any two units, we can say that both are associate, and we have any associate of a unit is also a unit. We start with two units u1 and u2. Units means these units have multiplicative inverses, say u1 prime and u2 prime. Then we have u1 prime equal to 1, u2 prime is equal to 1. Now we need to prove that u1 and u2 are associates. Say u1 is equal to 1 times u1, that is u2 prime into u1, that is equal to u2 into u3, where u3 is equal to u2 prime u1, that is a unit. Therefore, u1 and u2 are associates. Now, we start with a unit u and an associate of the unit v. And we'll prove that this v is also a unit. For that, since this u is a u, v is an associate of a u, we can write u is equal to u1 v for some unit u1. Then v is equal to u1 inverse u. That is, v is also a unit, since u1 inverse and u are units. The third statement is x and y are associates if and only if x divides y and y divides x. For the proof, first we assume x and y are associates. So x can be written as uy, that implies y divides x. X equal to uy means y equal to u inverse x, that implies x divides y. So we can say that y divides x and x divides y if x and y are associates. Conversely, we assume x divides y and y divides x. That implies y equal to z1x and x equal to z2y. These two statements together imply that by substituting for x, we can get y into 1 minus z1 z2 equal to 0. That implies x equal to 0 and y equal to 0. If y equal to 0, obviously x equal to 0. Then both are associates. Otherwise, we have z1 and z2 are units. So if z1 and z2 are units, then we can get y and x are associates. This proves the statement C. The fourth statement is x is an irreducible if and only if every divisor of x is an associate or a unit. So first we take an irreducible x, and we consider a divisor y of x. That means y divides x. We will prove that this y is either an associative or a unit. Y divides x implies x equal to yz for some z. Then the factorization is not proper because we know that x is an irreducible. Then we have either y or z is a unit. Z is a unit means y is an associate. Y is a unit means y has multiplicative inverse. So the statement implies y is a unit or y is an associate. So this proves the first part, necessary part. Conversely, assume x equal to yz. To prove x is an irreducible, we consider a factorization. X equal to yz. Then y is a divisor. That implies y is a unit or y is an associate. This is by assumption. Then this implies y is a unit or z is a unit. This implies x equal to yz is not a proper factorization. So this shows that x is an irreducible. Next we have fifth result. An associate of an irreducible is irreducible. So let's start with an irreducible, x be an irreducible, and we consider an associate of that. So x equal to y into u for some unit. Now consider a factorization of y. We need to prove that y is an irreducible. So we consider a factorization and we'll prove that that factorization is not proper. So y is equal to ab. That implies x equal to abu. That implies either a is a unit or b is a unit. That implies y is equal to ab is a is not a proper factorization. Hence, result follows. Now we have a remark. 0 is not an irreducible because 0 has a proper factorization. 0 is equal to 0 into 0. Both zeros are non-units, so that is a proper factorization, so it cannot be considered as an irreducible. Next we will prove proposition 4.4. The statements are, there are a number of statements are there. If D is a domain and x, y are non-zero elements of D, then if we consider the concepts of ideal, we can get x divides y if and only if ideal generated by x is ideal generated by x contains ideal generated by y. So we prove this. We know that what is an ideal generated by x. So this is what we call the principal ideal. This is set of all multiples of x, okay, Rx such that R belongs to D. So x divides y implies this y can be written as x z for some z. That implies y belongs to the ideal generated by x. That implies ry is equal to rxz implies that belongs to ideal generated by x. That implies ideal generated by y contained in ideal generated by x. Conversely, if ideal generated by x contains ideal generated by y, implies y belongs to this ideal generated by x, then y is equal to xz for some z. This implies x divides y. The next statement is x and y are associates if and only if ideal generated by x and ideal generated by y are same. But in the previous theorem, we know that x and y are associate if and only if x divides y and y divides x. Using that, you can easily get ideal generated by x contained in ideal generated by y, ideal generated by y contained in ideal generated by x. Then these two statements together imply that ideal generated by x is equal to ideal generated by y. Now we can prove the third statement. X is a unit, then there exists v belongs to D such that xv is equal to 1. X is a unit, then ideal generated by x is always equal to D. Ideal generated by x is always contained in D, that is trivial. Y belongs to D, comma y is equal to 1 into y, that is equal to xv into y, that implies ideal generated by x. That implies D is contained in ideal generated by x, that implies ideal generated by x is equal to D. Conversely, assume that ideal generated by x is equal to D, then we will prove that x is a unit. Then 1 belongs to ideal generated by x. Then 1 can be written as a multiple of x. So the x is z such that 1 is equal to x into z. This implies that x is a unit. Then x is a unit if and only if ideal generated by x is same as the whole D. Next we'll prove fourth result. This is an interesting result and it is very important. We will use it later. For an irreducible x, the ideal generated by x is maximal among the proper principal ideals of D. So we need to prove the necessary part. Assume x is an irreducible. Let ideal generated by x contained. We need to prove that ideal generated by x is maximal. So if we consider an ideal in between ideal generated by x and ideal and D, that implies x belongs to ideal generated by y. That implies x equal to y is it. Implies y is a unit or y is z is a unit or y is a unit. Okay, because x is an irreducible, that implies y is an associate or y is a unit. That implies ideal generated by y is same as ideal generated by x, or ideal generated by y is equal to d. That is because of the previous result. That implies x is a maximal among all principal ideals. Now we will prove the converse part. Conversely, assume that the ideal generated by x is maximal among the proper principal ideals of d. For this, we will consider a factorization of x. We will prove that it is not proper. X equal to yz, and if x equal to yz, we have ideal generated by x contained in ideal generated by y, that is contained in d. That implies ideal generated by x equal to ideal generated by y, or ideal generated by y equal to d. That implies, since this is by the maximality of the ideal generated by x, by our assumption, x and y are, that implies x and y are associates, or y is a unit. Z, this implies x and y are associate means z is a unit. Then that implies x is an irreducible. That means whenever x equal to yz, then we can get z is a unit or y is a unit. So that factorization is not proper. This shows that x is an irreducible. This proves our proposition 4.4.